Today we're going to be talking about warm and cool colors. Colors can be warm, cool, or neutral. On a simple six-color color wheel, warm colors are on one side and cool colors are on the other. So if you have this simple color wheel, this side is warm, this side is cool. Warm colors remind me of a hot, dry desert, and cool colors remind me of a wet, cool forest. So this picture really helps me remember that red, orange, and yellow are warm, blue, green, and purple are cool. You might be wondering about some other colors. A color like pink would be warm because pink is red mixed with white. And red is a warm color, okay? So if you have a warm color that's lighter, like light orange, light red, which would be pink, light yellow, those are still warm. Even a dark red or a dark orange or a dark yellow, still warm. Turquoise, I was thinking about turquoise. Turquoise is like blue and green mixed together. So it would be cool because both blue and green are both cool colors, okay? What about a red orange, sort of a reddish orange? Well, red and orange are both warm colors. So a mix of them would be still warm, okay? And how about a color like light blue? Light blue would be, is blue mixed with some white if we were painting. So the main color in there is blue, so it's gonna be cool. There are other colors that are neutral, like gray, brown, tan, black, and white. These colors are neutral. They are not in the color wheel, and they're neither warm nor cool. So it is time for us to start our warm, cool project. To start, you can get your materials. You will need pencil, paper, something to color with like crayons or markers or colored pencils, whatever you have. A ruler is great if you have one, but you don't need it. You can use the side of a book if you want straight lines. And step two is to choose a simple shape to draw. So I drew some simple shapes here. Your shape should just be an outline with no details inside. So for example, this ice cream right here. I did the outline of the ice cream, but nothing inside. Okay, it has to be empty inside. You could trace your hand. I like to do a heart, but any simple shape you can think of that doesn't have anything inside. You are going to draw your shape nice and big on your paper. If your shape is teeny tiny on the paper, it's not going to be much fun to color in. So draw your shape nice and big with pencil. The next step is you're going to trace over that pencil with something dark. It could be a dark crayon, dark marker. I used a Sharpie, but I know not everybody has a Sharpie. You can use anything dark, but you're going to want your shape to have a nice dark outline, okay? Then we're going to switch back to pencil, put that dark color away and grab a pencil. You are going to draw lines going across your paper. Use a ruler or edge of a book if you have one. If not, you can just draw them freehand. So these are actually called horizontal lines, okay? They are going from left to right, horizontal lines. I'm going to go all the way down until I fill up the paper. Next, in pencil, draw lines going up and down your paper. So now we have a grid. Time to color. Color inside of your shape with warm colors. Color outside of your shape with cool colors. So I did a heart for my shape. Inside my heart's warm. Outside my heart is cool. And I have some coloring tips for you. When you color in your project, take your time and make sure you color in all of the space. I put a little example over here. Your project is going to have a much more finished look if you color in your whole shape. These ones are not colored all the way. These ones are. Also, sometimes I make a mistake and I draw cool on the inside or warm on the outside. And to help not make that mistake, I like to separate my colors. I put my warm crayons to one side and my cool colors to the other side. And then it helps me not draw the wrong color in the wrong spot. So it's a helpful tip.